Hey friends, Windows Admin Center is a single pane of glass that consolidates all aspects of your local and remote server management. But did you know that you can extend your on-premises deployments of Windows Server to the cloud by using Azure Hybrid Services? Thomas is here to show me how easy it is today on Azure Friday. Hey, it's Azure Friday, and I'm here with Thomas, who's going to teach me how to connect Windows servers, and I've got some, like, under my desk at the office, to connect them to Azure with Azure Hybrid Services. How is it possible?
Exactly. So everyone has servers under your desk, right, as of today. As you said, there are a lot of companies out there and organizations which still use servers, and they have deployed on-prem servers for years, for example, also in factories or, like, shops and things like that, right? Mm-hmm. So we want to give the IT pros a possibility to easily manage them and then take advantage of the cloud to make their on-prem infrastructure even better. Mm-hmm. And with that, we use Windows Admin Center, which makes it super, super easy.
Okay. So is that something that I have to install on my local machine, or is this an Azure thing? Where does it live?
You can basically install wherever you want it. So we have most customers deploying it on-prem, but you can also deploy it on an Azure virtual machine to manage your Windows servers as well.
Okay. So do you have a couple of Windows servers yourself?
Oh, yes. So I have a couple of servers here, like the typical ones, the main controllers, file servers, like the stuff you just have, right?
Right.
Here on my desk. So let's have a quick look, actually, at Windows Admin Center. So here, this is Windows Admin Center. And you can see here that I have, for example, the main controller and file servers and things like that. And if we have a quick look at this domain controller, you can see I can do a lot of pretty things, like managing things which were ugly MMCs before. We can now use, for example, a web-based certificates manager or device manager and things like that.
Well, and this kind of looks in the same style as the portal, right? Except I've got like a portal for managing my company on-premise instead of in the cloud.
Exactly. So it's a web-based portal where you can install it, and there you can also do multi-management for different servers and users. And it remote manages those servers. It uses PowerShell remoting in the background to access those servers.
I see. And I noticed that your URL is .local, so you're showing me that this is really happening here.
Exactly.
And not at some domain in the cloud.
No, exactly. So this one here, everything is running locally in my environment, and it's not running in the cloud at all.
Yeah.
But what I want to do now is I want to take advantage of some of those cool services in Azure, right? So if you run virtual machines in Azure, you know that you can run Azure Backup and Azure Site Recovery and a lot of other things. So if we have a look here, we go to Azure Hybrid Services here. You can see that it loads up and it tells me a little bit the story, what I can do, and it will start listing all those servers, all those services I can use. So if I go to Discover Services, you can see here the list of services I have available. So this can, for example, be Azure Site Recovery, Azure Network Adapter, Monitor, Update Management, Backup, and a lot more services you can use, right, for your on-prem server.
Interesting. And let's just take a moment here, because I think a lot of people think that the cloud and people who work in the cloud, they want you to take that server running under your desk and lift and shift and move it to the cloud. And what you're saying is maybe that solution's not for everyone. Maybe you don't want to pick up your server and throw it in the cloud. Maybe you just want to light it up.
Exactly.
With cloud features.
Exactly, Scott. That's exactly the case. Again, customers sometimes choose not to do something in the cloud, but sometimes they don't have another choice, right? So for example, if you want to run something very important in a factory, you probably don't want to rely on the internet connectivity. So you still deploy a couple of servers on-prem as well.
Okay. So you're saying that I can get these features, I can get file sync, I can get backup without having to move my server?
Yes, exactly.
So I'll believe it when I see it, sir.
So let's have a look at it.
Let's do it.
Now, so one of the things which we see a lot is like disaster recovery, right? Disaster recovery can be very complex and very expensive to do. And so with ASR and Azure Site Recovery, we have a very simple solution here. And if I go down, for example, so let's have a look again on my Hyper-V server here. This is where I run all my virtual machines on. And I can also manage that using Windows Admin Center. And if I scroll down here, you can see all my virtual machines running on that specific on-prem Hyper-V server.
Okay.
And if I go to inventory, you can see here that I run four virtual machines here, like two app servers and two file servers. And if I want to now protect that virtual machine, like from a failure of that Hyper-V server, I can simply replicate that file server to Azure. So if I do that, I go simply into my server, click on more, protect virtual machine, And then you can see that since I already set up the environment to connect to Azure, you can see it already selected my subscription, it already selected my Azure region, my recovery vault, and then the only thing I can specify is I want to use a new storage account or if I want to use the existing one.
Did I have to install anything in this VM? Did I have to remote in? If I might, I mean, if I have four VMs, that would be not a big deal, but if I have 100, I might not want to go and install a bunch of things. Yep. Is this able to do this just with WMI and PowerShell and Magic?
Absolutely. So what I did before that, I set up that Hyper-V server and it installed the Azure Site Recovery agent and everything directly from like Windows Admin Center. And the great thing, it also created all the Azure resources I need. So for example, the Site Recovery Vault, which placed in Azure the resource groups and everything, everything was created from Windows Admin Center.
Mm. This is huge. I mean, you know, there's so many people out there that are honestly, they're running this machine at, you know, on-prem, and I don't even know if they have a backup, or maybe they've never even thought about it.
Yeah.
They could do this in a weekend.
Exactly, exactly. So let me quickly show you. I already have a VM enabled for that, because obviously the initial replication takes some time. Mm-hmm. So we have here a virtual machine here, and you can see here it says protected. So when I click on that virtual machine.
Ah, now you've gone from a local admin server, now you're in the cloud because that's where you save the backup.
Exactly, exactly. So you can see here, now I'm in the Azure portal, right? And you can see here that just one server shows up, but you can imagine that if I have hundreds of servers, all of them show up. Mm-hmm. And you can see here that it's healthy, it's protected. And so if I go a little bit deeper, you can also see that I have to still some finished tasks I need to do, right? So if I click on that.
Oh, I see, because you haven't actually tested the failover. If the VM dies, what happens?
Exactly, that's one thing. And then Azure Site Recovery and Windows Admin Center is so smart, it takes over, for example, the name of the virtual machine, it takes over the size and matches it to an Azure virtual machine size. But there are things like the Azure Resource Group or the virtual network, which it cannot define, right? It needs to, someone needs to basically explain that to you, to that virtual machine. So that's what we would do here. And then when I have done this task, what I can do is I have different options here. So first thing I want to do is I don't want to wait until a disaster strikes, right? Mm-hmm. I want to test my failover. So I can really click test failover. This will create a completely new virtual network, completely isolated, and will start up my virtual machine in there. So it does not have any effect on production, but I can test the application if it's working and the virtual machine which is working. The other thing I can do is the failover button. That's the one I need when I have a disaster. And for example, my Hyper-V server is not reachable at all anymore, but I need the application. And the last one is the so-called plant failover. Now, plant failover, what it does is it shuts down the virtual machine on-prem and then replicates the latest changes. And then it starts the virtual machine in Azure. So I don't have any data loss or anything. And this is great if I, for example, know tomorrow I have maintenance and I need to shut down my server, but it should still run so people can do their work. I can fail it over in a planned failover to Azure.
Okay, and then how would you get back after that planned thing happens?
So what you can do is then you can also fail back if you need to do that, but you can also leave it running. So it's a very good migration scenario as well.
So it sets you up for success if in some case in the future you do want to lift and shift. This actually makes it even easier to do that.
Absolutely. Since you only pay for like after the first 30 days, you know, it's free. So it's a great thing to migrate your virtual machines, especially if you have a small environment, you need to migrate a couple of virtual machines. You can also use that tool to basically freely migrate your virtual machines to Azure.
That's a really smart thing to do. And it's also worth pointing out, as we mentioned, that a lot of people don't have backups. There's an old joke in the world of the backup community. It's backups always succeed. It's the restorers that fail.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
So what an amazing thing that you've built failover testing into the UI itself.
Exactly. So this is fantastic, right? This is really gives you the power to basically protect your on-prem environment using the cloud.
Okay. Well, protecting them is not just backing them up, but it's also keeping them fresh, keeping them updated.
Absolutely.
Is that something I can do as well?
Yes. So this is a great point. So updating is another part of it. Right. We need to make sure that if you run virtual machines everywhere, this can be run in local data center, it can run in factory floors, it can run even in other cloud providers. But keeping them up to date is really difficult because you probably use multiple tools. You use one in Azure, you use one on-prem, you use another one for another service provider or other locations. Now, for that, we have Windows Azure Update Management. Right. So what we can do here, if we scroll down, you can see here I can manage updates on that server.
That's actually the Windows Update icon right there, exactly. Which I recognize.
Exactly. So what happens here is basically I can do like normal, I can say install now and basically update that server and see the patches which you need to install. So what you can see here now, it's basically showing me the updates what I need to, which are on that server available, and mm-hmm. I can just click and install it now. But what I can also do is I can go and connect it to Azure. So here we are in the Azure Update Management solution, and I've connected two servers in that Azure Update Management solution. So if you look at here.
Oh, it says platform non-Azure.
Exactly. So I have my Azure VM here, and I have my on-prem VM here next to each other. And I can use the same Update Management solution for both on-prem VMs and Azure VMs.
So it's like running Windows Update for your entire organization, both in the cloud and on-premises.
Absolutely.
That is cool.
So what do I need to know? It shows me that they are not compliant. This shows that there are updates missing. So to basically fix that, I can just basically schedule an update deployment, which I give a name. So I do hybrid.
Oh, and both Windows and Linux as well.
Exactly. It shows me like Windows and Linux. I need to choose that for my update deployment, but depending on the virtual machines, because there are some fundamental changes to that. And then I can select the virtual machines. I can obviously group them, but in my case, we're just going to go and basically select those machines. So for example, you can see here my two virtual machines. I'm going to add those. And you can see here now they're in that update deployment job. Mm-hmm. I can then go and do some additional configuration, like select the classifications, or for example, like schedule the update, which is really helpful. Mm-hmm. So what you can do is you can do a one-time deployment, right? So it goes now out and deploys. But you can also say, okay, I want to do a recurrent update, for example, weekly or monthly, and basically schedule that and group my servers and schedule that and deploy those updates to those servers.
It's really nice the way that it's very clean, that there's no real differentiation between on-premises and not. Like you just have one, as you say, one pane of glass to go and manage all of this stuff.
Exactly. That's really, really, really powerful, right? Especially if you have like multiple locations and everything you need to take care of. So this really, really helps.
Go ahead.
Yeah. So after that, you basically just click on create, and this will create a new update job, and then it goes out and patches these servers. So what I'm going to do here is what I already have done that. So you see here, I created a job called on-prem. And that specific job run already through. So I patched my one machine. It installed three updates. So I can exactly see what's going on. If there, for example, some updates failed or something is not right, I can see that directly in my console.
So all of this stuff, all these great things that we've seen that are all starting with Windows Admin Center and Azure Hybrid Services, people can do this now. Like they have this capability. They just haven't turned it on and set it up for themselves.
Exactly. The only thing they need is download Windows Admin Center. This is basically free. If you run Windows Server, you just can download Windows Admin Center. You can manage 2019, but it can also go down to all the way to 2008 and 2008 R2 if you still have machines.
I actually have a 2008 R2 machine.
Exactly. So you can use it for that as well. There are some features which are not available there. But then basically it can also help you to migrate those virtual machines to newer versions.
Fantastic. I am learning all about Azure Hybrid Services and the power of Windows Admin Center today on Azure Friday.